So today I'm going to do a video on the basics of how to whistleblow. First and foremost, I am not an attorney. I am what I call one, an enthusiast and an amateur whistleblower, right? An amateur at anything, but I have a passion, right? So first and foremost, we'll start off with the definition, and I'm going to be taking a look at my notes because that I did in a receipt because there's a lot of information. So what is a definition of a whistleblower? Really, a whistleblower is an employee who works for a corporation, private or public, nonprofit, for-profit, small or big, but you are bringing forward illicit behavior or illegal, you're bringing forward illicit behavior or unethical practices within your workplace. That's the bottom line, right? And so that's a whistleblower. And I'm gonna tell you guys, it is not easy being a whistleblower. You have to really understand that doing the right thing is not always the easiest thing, but I want to encourage every union member, be ethical, uphold your contract bargaining agreements, and really, we have a lot of protection. We have to have just cause in order to get fired. So I say, fuck with it. Now, before you want to do it, I really want to encourage you to, one, understand your CBA. Two, understand your board policies. Any policy that your employer has, know it, because you will use that against them. Two. And number three, try to get familiar with your state and federal laws so that you can apply it to that as well. Now, let's see here. My advice really when whistleblowing is always go through chain of command. You always want to give your employer the benefit of the doubt and try to give them an opportunity to correct action. I'm going to be frank with you. Employers do not like whistleblowers. It is a tough thing to put your name to a complaint. But if you're a union member, do not be scared, but be mentally prepared because they will come after you. They will fuck with you. And the beauty of it is if you know your rights, you know your CBA, you know their board policies, you can fuck with them too. And eventually they will know that you know and will leave you alone. With the ultimate goal being fix the problem. Now, let's say we have an issue, you bring it forward. If you want to remain anonymous, this is also, let's see here. So you have an issue, you want to remain anonymous, that's fine. You can always contact outside agencies and use Google. Google will be your friend. Depends on the work of line that you do, right? So you can blow the whistle and contact OSHA if it's a safety violation, civil rights, if it's a civil rights issue, the Department of Civil Rights. Everything is readily available to you on your computer and Google. Now, anonymous versus, do you want to remain anonymous? I think many people do want to remain anonymous, but mainly because there's a stigma behind being a whistleblower. I think that it's so very important to remove the stigma. If it weren't for whistleblowers, things would be shit. I believe in whistleblowers. I think they're not given the respect that they deserve. But that's my opinion. If you want to remain anonymous, do it. If you don't, go through chain of command. I think it's the best way to give the your employer an opportunity to remedy the solution. They will come after you. Know your rights. Fight back. So my basic tips for this video are, how do you whistleblow? Well, you go through a chain of command or you do it through an outside agency. Outside agency will come. Hopefully your employer will try to remedy the solutions if you go through them. But really, documents, documents, documents. I can't stress that enough. You always want to have yourself a little notepad for your notes, what you're observing, what you're seeing, dates, times, everything, who's involved, who's not involved, etc. To the detail when you can. Also, another thing is you want to create a personal account, a different email account. And you know, we have our phones out all the time. You can be emailing yourself notes. And then at the end in court, your email account can get subpoenaed and can be used as a form of testimony. Also, you want to be careful with videotaping people in public, in private places. It is against the law. You don't want to record them either in meetings. It is against the law. And even though it's powerful evidence, it will not, it will be thrown out in court. Look up wiretap laws. Those are very important to know because a lot of people don't realize that that is illegal. There's also FERPA laws. If you work with schools, look into that. You can't really tape students. It's a privacy of their violation of their privacy. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Let me see. Yeah, so basically, if your employer does not correct the actions, then you go big. You're going to expose the truth, right? So as your last resource, you really want to understand your audience. You want to organize and mobilize, and then you want to talk to media. You can always blow the whistle and reach out to media. That's not a problem. So the last step is reaching out to media and exposing the unethical or illicit behavior, and really in hopes to find a solution to the problem. That's ultimately it. Really understand your amendment rights as well. You know, if you work for a private company, be careful. You can't just pop off. You don't have the same rights as public employees. However, that's not to say that public employees can pop off at work regarding, you know, the things that they are witnessing or reporting. Once you're on the clock, you have to be careful. You can't just exercise your First Amendment right. It's all circumstantial. You also have Amendment 14. So be very aware of that. Freedom of speech is very powerful when used off the clock, especially if it is in the best interest of the public to know. And ultimately, when you do whistleblow, you are considered protected class, California Labor Code Section 110.2.5. Look it up. And you have a legal right to be protected. You have a legal right to whistleblow and not face retaliation or discrimination. If you're a union member, I say blow the whistle. If you're a non-union member, I say blow the whistle. It's the ethical thing to do and unionize. I hope this really helps. Solidarity to all. And DM me questions and I'll be more than happy to help. Bye.